Hey everyone, welcome you all. In this video, we are going to discuss about CoAP message format. So if you are new to the channel, please guys hit the like button and subscribe the channel. And coming to the CoAP message format here, so it has got some parameters. So there is the first one is the version that is indicated as VER, and then the T is there, then TKL is there, then code is there, and followed by that code the message ID is present. So below that the token will be there, then options if exist, and payload. So payload indicates the actual data which has to be transferred, so this is equivalent to the data itself. And coming to the individual explanation of these fields which are present, so first one is the version. So it is of 2-bit length, so it has got a length of 2 bits and it denotes the version of CoAP. So version of CoAP means what version of CoAP we are using. So the recent one is the 4.1.1, so it can be a 2.1.1, 3.1.1. so depending on the version, so the value of VER will be changing. So if two devices are interacting with each other, then it is very necessary that they should use the same version. So if one is using 3.1.1 and other is using 2.1.1, then the connection will not happen between these two. So the error will come, that is the version code error. So to avoid that, we should indicate the version of the CoAP which we are using at our end, so that the communication can happen. So that is the significance of the version in case of message format. And the second one is T. So T indicates, so it is also having same length, that is 2 bits here, and it indicates the message type. So it indicates what type of message we are sending. So either it can be confirmable, non-confirmable, or whether it is an acknowledgement for some request or a response, and whether it is a reset. So that is so they have got a codes here. So zero code. So if you enter t equal to zero, so t equal to zero, if you enter at that time, it indicates that the present message which you are sending now is the confirmable message. That is, it will be expecting an confirmation or the acknowledgement from the server. So if the T value is equal to 1, at that time it is type of non-confirmable message, where the client will be not accepting any acknowledgement from the server. And if it is provided T equal to 3, at that time it indicates this is the acknowledgement for some request which has been already sent. And if it is 3, then it is type of a reset. So that is the significance of T in the message format. And then coming to the TKL, so TKL is the token length. So it indicates the length of the token which is here. So what will be the length of this token is indicated here. So whether it will be 2 bits, 3 bits, 4 bits, or how many bits it will be. So the length of this TKL is 4 bits. So it is having 4 bits in it. So 2, 3, and 4. So this is the length of 4 bits. So up to 16 in decimal, it can address the token length. Okay, so the next field in the message format is code. So what is mean by code is, so it is 8 bit in length. So the length of this code is 8 bits, and it indicates the code response. So it indicates what type of code it is sending. So if the code value is equal to 0, then it is type of a request. And if it is the code value is equal to 2, then it is type of a successful response. And if the code value is 4, then client error response. And if the code value is 5, at that time it will be server error response. So it will indicate what type of response the message format is. So whether it is a request, or whether it is a response, or whether it is a client error, or whether it is a server error. So it has got a different codes, so on. So I have listed some. So for more information, you can check the Google. So next field in the communication message is the message ID. So a message ID is having a length of 16 bits. So it is the highest length which is having, and it is used to match messages of type acknowledgement reset to messages of type confirmable and non-confirmable respectively. So it is used to make the matches here. So The acknowledgement is for the confirmable message and reset is for the non-confirmable messages. So that is used to match these two things here. And the last field which you can say is token. So what is mean by token? It is used to correlate request and responses. So here the client will be there and the server will be there. So it is used to correlate the request. So it will be sending some request and we need to send some response. So the token is, it will be having a token number, let us say 1. So with a token number 1, some subscriber has sent the query. So we need to send the response to him only. So that token number is taken and copied over here. And for that token number, the response will be sent from the server. So to correlate the request and responses, the token is used. And that's all about the MQTT message format, guys. And here the options are there. So this is the option if you want some extra. And it is reserved for now. And the payload is present here. So payload is, as I already said, it is the ultimate data which you want to transfer. So if client is there and server is there, you want to know the temperature at particular point. And the temperature will be like a payload. So it will be sent to the server here. So thanks for watching. See you in the next video. So if you are new to the channel, please guys, subscribe the channel and hit the like button. Thank you. Thanks for watching.